A weather spotter Dylan Davis caught this would-be tornado on his cell phone 6 miles outside of Woodland yesterday. The National Weather Service had put a tornado warning out there earlier in the day for that area, and there were no reports of damage. Now, Sean, this is an actual tornado,
no,
right?
That was what you call a funnel cloud. As soon as it does touch the ground, then it's, you know, Auntie M, it's a twister, it's a twister. You know,
because luckily, get Toto and
you can joke about that right now because it didn't hit the ground. That actually looked pretty sizable. And there's been some reports of possible funnel clouds off of the Palos Verdes Peninsula. We do get them in California. It's very rare, and they're usually pretty small. And we do. They don't usually make much more than just nice pictures.
Well, that's good.
That's good news.
I like the pictures. That's it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, because we do get them here. All right, let's go ahead and look at some more pictures. This is from Elizabeth Brooks and her lovely husband, Rick. Nice people here. They always help us out and show stuff. And maybe that's not the proper term to say lovely husband. Maybe you could have said that.
Oh, okay. He could be a lovely husband.
All right.
And he takes lovely photos.
Yeah, there you go.
That?
The washover you can see right there. I think that's Gaviota. And then right here looks like Ledbetter, and you can see someone's bike. Boy, that's a surprise. You come back with seaweed stuck in the sprocket there. And, of course, other pictures, too. We also saw some other activity, and that's down in Ventura. Those are my kids right there watching the water rush down the beach. It was actually going toward their elementary school. That's how I bribed my son, Jack, to come and watch. I said, your school's getting wet. And he's like, cool, let's go watch. And then he asked me, is there school tomorrow? I said, no, it's Sunday. All right, there we go. Storm slowly winding down. Showers through early Sunday. Surf stays high. That might be our really big focus for the next day or so. And then drying out next week. And you can see in the latest radar, most of the energy is still remaining well. Well, it's actually moving to our east as we speak. A lot of the bulk of energy has shifted to our southeast, but there's still a lot of energy coming in off the ocean, so showers are possible. And you can see on the pinpoint for Ventura, went ahead and decided to keep this right here, right about the 101 coming out of Camarillo to the Oxnard region. So that might be about Rose Avenue right about there, if I do my math or my geography right. That's a pretty significant little cell right there. And whenever you see the reds, you're definitely seeing some high energy, some high cloud top energy, which means you might actually get funnel clouds or at least some thunder out of that. We'll have to keep an eye on that. Watches and advisories are mainly to our south and southeast, but of course we do have the surf along the coast. And on the future cast, you'll notice right here, we do have some energy out there still kind of working through the region. That will likely start to wind down tomorrow as we begin to see the storm system move out of the area. So by Sunday noon or so, it looks like we'll pretty much be done with it. And by Monday, just some clouds lingering across the area. So at least we're going to start to dry things out. The storm, the rainmaker is weakening as we speak. And as we put the other map into motion, watch this, the kind of a wider shot of the Pacific. There is another system out there, and you'll notice it's right there. But high pressure is expected to fill in the next couple of days and keep things at bay. So there you go with what to expect one last time. Storm winding down. Showers possible through Sunday. 25 hundredths of an inch or more, about a quarter of an inch is still possible. And then we do expect to dry out as we head into the next couple of days. There's your forecast for tomorrow. 60s across the board, not really on the warm side, decreasing energy by the afternoon. Surf forecast is still going to remain big, but at least the high tides right now are not so bad, and they're more or less around 10 a.m. and 10 p.m., so that's when the water can come hot, the highest up the beach. And there's your quick look at your forecast. We'll go ahead and dry things out. Windy conditions possibly by the middle of the week, but you'll notice the temperature is going back up into the 70s. San Luis Obispo, we'll go ahead and stop on this map. P.m. chance of rain again once we get to Thursday, and that is because another storm system may get down, its tail end may end up getting into northern San Luis Obispo County, and that would be about Thursday night. But it looks like we'll dry out for at least the next couple days for sure for everybody.
Okay. All right. Thanks for that, Sean. More news ahead, but first here, Senator De Los Santos with a preview of sports.
That's right.